Why newly discovered Unimon is a quantum computer breakthrough. Although superconducting qubits appear to hold promise for practical quantum computers, the widely used qubit designs and fabrication processes now available do not yet deliver adequate performance. The Unimon superconducting qubit improves the precision of quantum computing and has a series of desired traits, including higher anharmonicity, total insensitivity to direct current charge noise, reduced sensitivity to magnetic noise, and a straightforward structure consisting only of a single Josephson junction in a resonator for a single circuit. On three Unimon qubits, the team was able to obtain accuracy ranging from 99.8% to 99.9% with single-qubit gates lasting 13 nanoseconds. In the effort to create commercially viable quantum computers, this is a significant breakthrough. The goal is to construct quantum computers that provide an advantage in solving real-world issues, which is also known as quantum supremacy. The announcement of the Unimon qubit marks a critical turning point for IQM and advances development for superior superconducting quantum computers. According to quantum physics researchers, Unimons may operate faster, resulting in fewer errors per operation, because their anharmonicity or nonlinearity is larger than that of transmons qubits. To experimentally prove the Unimon, the researchers created chips with three Unimon qubits, while the niobium was used as superconducting material apart from the Josephson junctions. The geometric inductance of the Unimon has the potential to be more predictable and yield-enhancing than the junction array-based superconductors employed in conventional quartan or fluxonium qubits. There is still a ton of room for significant advancements given the incredible performance of the first Unimon qubit. As the next steps, the quantum researchers are planning improvements for even greater noise protection and demonstrate two-qubit gates. For practical quantum advantage with noisy systems and effective quantum error correction, the quantum researchers say they strive for additional advancements in their design, materials, and gate time of the Unimon. This new superconducting Unimon qubit was developed by a team of researchers from Aalto University, IQM Quantum Computers, and VTT Technical Research Center. The simplicity and advantages of Unimons over transmons are numerous because the Unimon qubit measured by the researchers had a relatively high anharmonicity, was noise immune, and only required a single Josephson junction. Breakthrough tentacle robot revolutionizes gripping. Once more, science fiction is starting to resemble science fact. An octopus, a mess of sentient spaghetti, or those flying tentacle monster bots from the Matrix are all reminiscent of a new soft tentacle robot gripper. It's modeled after curly hair, and although having a strange appearance, it symbolizes a very delicate method of handling delicate goods. The strange new tentacle robot is a creation of the John A. Paulson School of Engineering and Applied Sciences at Harvard University, and the robotics researchers recently submitted a paper describing their findings to the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences Journal. The robot's delightfully straightforward design inflates its tentacle robot arms to activate its grip. It's made to entangle things without hurting them, but the individual filaments that make up the tentacles aren't very strong on their own. However, when used as a group, these filament tentacles can firmly grasp and hold items of all shapes and sizes. The tentacles are rubber tubes that curl up when inflated because one side of the tubes has thicker walls than the other. The robot might be used as a gripper for medical applications or to handle fragile goods like fruits or glassware, according to the researchers. Simple sensors and software are sufficient for the robot to work, allowing the robot arm to use these extremely versatile filaments instead of typical robot grippers that need complex artificial intelligence algorithms. How this quantum physics breakthrough resulted in a quantum engine. Chinese quantum physics researchers claim to have created a quantum engine that can power nanorobots inside of human bodies by using a single atom as a motor. The Chinese Academy of Sciences Institute of Physics and Mathematics has overcome a barrier to successfully operate a power system at the atomic scale by accurately controlling the state of a quantum ion using a laser. Although quantum physics-driven systems are particularly susceptible to outside disturbances, there will always be an energy exchange with the outside world. But now, a quantum engine capable of withstanding outside disturbances was created thanks to an advancement in laser technology, according to a study published in the journal Nature Communications. The four-stroke operation of a steam engine involves the four thermodynamic phases of adiabatic compression, isovolumic heating, adiabatic expansion, and isovolumic cooling. The quantum engine functions by using a single calcium ion, which serves as the working medium in the physicist's quantum engine, and laser beams with various frequencies and intensities drive the compression or heating operations of each cycle. It's even possible to observe the ions changing modes because the engine produces light with varying intensities for each stage. The efficiency of the heat engine was originally thought to increase with the strength of the ion's quantum characteristic, with a quantum engine's operational efficiency only being relevant to the motor's starting power. However, the quantum physics researchers discovered that the most effective technique to achieve the various engine modes was to systematically increase and repress the ion's quantum characteristic, instead of always increasing it. This quantum engine proposal defies conventional wisdom, explores cutting-edge science, and has caused disagreement among certain scientists. Because the study was so groundbreaking and somewhat contentious, the submission process for the publication took more than a year. However, after repeated testing of theory and experimentation, the work was accepted. The quantum physics researchers said the fundamental purpose of the research is to demonstrate the discovery of an appropriate working medium, similar to the water vapor used in a steam engine, in order to create useful molecular motors to power nanorobots. Finding the precise point when the laser helps the engine to produce the most output power is one of the team's next two future research directions. The other research direction is to build a cold machine by reversing the engine cycle, using the same idea as a refrigerator's compressor. Robot dog uses a brand new approach to walk almost anywhere. A robotic system developed by scientists at the University of California, Berkeley, and Carnegie Mellon University's School of Computer Science enables a cheap, small-legged robot to climb and descend stairs that are nearly its height, navigate rocky, slippery, uneven, steep, and varied terrain, walk across gaps, scale rocks and curbs, and even operate in the dark. In a simulator, the researchers used 4,000 copies of the robot to train it to walk and climb over difficult terrain. The robot acquired 6 years' worth of experience in a single day because of the simulator's quickness. Additionally, the simulator gained motor abilities during training and stored them in a neural network that the researchers replicated in the actual robot. This method deviated from conventional ones by not requiring any manual engineering of the robot's movements. The majority of robotic systems employ cameras to map their surroundings and plan their motions before actually carrying them out, but this process is often slow and susceptible to many interferences. By circumventing the traditional mapping and planning stages, this new approach sends vision inputs directly to the robot's control. The robot dog moves in response to what it perceives without receiving any instructions from the researchers. This method enables the robot dog to respond swiftly to approaching terrain and navigate it successfully. The robot dog used by the researchers was about 25 times less expensive than traditional devices because there was no mapping or planning required as a result of the movements being learned by artificial intelligence. The team's approach is expected to significantly increase accessibility of low-cost robotics devices.